Ja, und damit sage ich wieder Hallo und herzlich willkommen zurück bei einer neuen Folge Casey Rain. Wir haben ja dank dem alten Wade letztes Mal einiges rausgefunden. Unter anderem, dass die Bilder von Lilly alle gestohlen wurden. Und nachdem wir wissen, dass der aktuelle Sheriff damals ermittelt hat, wenn auch nicht sonderlich erfolgreich, werden wir dem guten Mann jetzt mal einen Besuch abstatten, auch wenn der nicht gerade unser bester Freund ist. Aber wir hoffen jetzt einfach mal, dass Wade schon mit ihm telefoniert hat, dass uns der so ein paar Türen öffnet.
Hey, Lenny.
Hello, Kathy. What's up?
Nah, I don't want to ask him about that. Do you know who Jimmy Cochran is?
Not really, Kathy. Sorry.
Gott, der Typ ist so nützlich.
Nah, I don't want to ask him about that. Do you know anything about a weird bald guy dressed in red around here?
You're joking, right?
Oh, never mind. Well, gotta go.
See ya.
Gut, dann eben nicht. Dann müssen wir halt wohl mit dem Chef persönlich reden.
Hello, Sheriff. Mind if I ask you a few more questions?
If you must.
Do you know anything about the art theft in the Wade estate?
Yes, Mr. Wade phoned ahead about that. Lenny!
Yes, boss.
Get the report from the burglary in the Wade estate back in 86.
On it, boss. There you go, Kathy.
Thanks, buddy.
Na, immerhin kann er Anweisungen befolgen. Also, wir haben einen Polizeibericht vom 11.03.1986 um 1:12 Uhr. Der Alarm auf dem Wade-Anwesen wurde ausgelöst. Das Haus steht derzeit leer. Die Polizei wurde von den Nachbarn herbeigerufen. 11.03.86, 2:04 Uhr. Beamte erscheinen am Tatort. Mehrere eingeschlagene Fenster können entdeckt werden. Bei der Durchsuchung des Anwesens und des umgebenden Geländes kann keine Spur der Täter ausfindig gemacht werden. 12.3. Auch um 22? Egal. 12.3.1986, 2:20 Uhr. Ein einzelner Zeuge, identifiziert als Franklin Goldfarb, berichtet, dass mehrere Diebe den Tatort verlassen haben. 12.4. 1986, 0:15 Uhr. Charles Wade kommt in Cornwall Springs an, um eine offizielle Stellungnahme abzugeben. Nachdem er das Haus inspiziert hat, berichtet er, dass Gemälde im Wert von über 15.000 Dollar gestohlen wurden. 26.04.86, 14 Uhr. Die fraglichen Kunstwerke sind noch nicht in Kreisen aufgetaucht, die normalerweise mit gestohlenen Waren in Verbindung gebracht werden. Untersuchung wird eingestellt, da keine weiteren Hinweise aufgetaucht sind. Okay. Müsste man natürlich
I
nur
gotta
noch
find this
wissen.
Goldfarb guy. Maybe he knows more about the burglary.
Ja, dieser Typ. Ich fürchte zwar
Hey,
nicht, dass er
Lenny.
was weiß.
Hello, Kathy. What's up?
Does the name Franklin Goldfarb mean anything to you?
Sounds familiar, but I can't place him.
Well, gotta go.
See ya.
Hello, Sheriff. Mind if I ask you a few more questions?
If you must.
Do you know who Jimmy Cochran is?
Nope.
I don't need to ask him that. Do you know anything about a weird bald guy dressed in red around here?
What the hell are you talking about?
Never mind. Does the name Franklin Goldfarb mean anything to you?
Never heard of him. Anything else?
Okay, so kommen wir nicht weiter.
That's all for now.
Good.
Da kommen wir so nicht weiter. Okay, wen haben wir denn da noch so im Angebot? Wir haben Lenny, wir haben den Sheriff. Wir könnten natürlich Wade fragen. Schauen wir mal, ob die uns was Näheres.
Again, I see.
I sure am. I had some more questions, Charles.
I'm listening.
Do you know who Franklin Goldfarb is?
I'm not familiar with that name.
Thanks, Charles. That's all I need for now.
You're welcome, Kathy. Come back anytime.
Okay, dann haben wir ja jetzt eigentlich nur noch die Oma über aus der Zeit. Dann werden wir halt nochmal die Oma besuchen. Eigentlich würde ich ja gern wissen, wer der rote Glatzkopf ist. Aber da sind wir noch überhaupt keinen Schritt weiter. Oder vielleicht ist der rote Glatzkopf Franklin Goldfarb. Ja, wir schauen. Wir schauen, Moment mal, wir schauen noch einfach.
No Goldfarb in here. Maybe he moved? I should ask around and see if anyone knows him. No result for that. Nope, couldn't find it.
Ja, wäre wahrscheinlich zu einfach gewesen. Haben die Telefonnummer?
Nope, couldn't find it.
Auch nicht. Okay, dann bleiben wir beim ursprünglichen Plan. Und fragen einfach mal die Oma.
Oh, hello, dear.
Mind if we talk for a bit, Grandma?
Not at all, dear. What's on your mind?
I don't see a reason to ask her about that. I don't see a reason to ask her about that.
Okay, habe ich mir fast gedacht. Dann haben wir das schon mal weg.
Do you know who Jimmy Cochran is? He was a friend of Grandpa's.
I believe he teaches at the flight school these days.
I don't think so, at least not anymore. I was told he was placed in a mental facility.
Really? He always struck me as a kind man, maybe a bit nervous and on edge, but not crazy.
There's more. I found out that Jimmy asked Grandpa for help not long before Grandpa ended up in that wheelchair. Jimmy sounded really desperate. I'm sure what happened to Grandpa that night had something to do with his cry for help.
You should go find the man then. Surely he must know something.
That's the plan. I just wondered if there's anything else you think I should know about him.
Not really. We haven't stayed in touch since Joseph was injured. I know that he had a wife, Agatha, and a son, James. Agatha passed away from cancer years ago, but as far as I know, James still lives in the city with his family.
Okay, thanks, Grandma.
Okay, wir werden also wahrscheinlich früher oder später doch mal in der Anstalt einlaufen müssen. Aber irgendwie hat sie ja vorhin gesagt, das geht heute nicht mehr.
Does the name Franklin Goldfarb mean anything to you?
Oh, that poor man. He used to be an upstanding citizen, you know. Now he's constantly drinking and keeps babbling on about that imaginary acting career of his.
Sad thing. Do you know where I can find him?
He's homeless, dear. Lost his job a few years ago and never really got back on his feet.
Okay, now I know who you're talking about. Thanks, Grandma. Looks like I'm gonna have to have a chat with Goober.
Yep, hört sich verdächtig danach an. Und da wissen wir ja.
I'll be back later.
So long.
Zum Glück, wo der gelandet ist, weil den haben wir selber im Krankenhaus eingeliefert. Den haben wir selber ins Krankenhaus gebracht. Es sollte also relativ leicht sein, den zu finden. Wobei mir gerade einfällt, wir haben ja hier noch unsere Freundin an Empfang, die uns so super gerne mag. Vielleicht wird es auch nicht ganz so einfach. Aber wir geben ihr mal noch eine Chance. Sie ist ja schließlich Mitarbeiter des Monats.
I need a word, Miss Mendez.
Wait, how do you know my name?
It's written on that board behind you, genius.
You have the eyesight of a bald eagle or something?
Eh, what can I say? I'm a freak of nature. What happened to Goober, anyway?
Who?
The guy who had the seizure?
Oh, he ran off somewhere. Kept babbling about a religious near-death experience.
Okay, thanks. She looks bored out of her mind. Pretty understandable, to be honest. I don't have anything else to say to her.
Okay, wenn das alles ist. Wenn das alles ist, dann würde ich fast vorschlagen, können wir jetzt auch bei der Kirche vorbeifahren. Ich habe da so eine Vermutung, wen wir da finden. Wenn nicht, dann können wir immerhin auch nochmal mit dem Priester quatschen. Und ja, wir schauen einfach mal.
Hello, Father.
Greetings, my child. I'm glad you decided to come here.
Yeah, but just so you know, I'm not here to join your church or anything.
Oh, I would never assume that.
Good. So, with that out of the way, I have some questions.
Anything you need. I'm Isaac Price.
Kathy. Kathy Rain, but I'm guessing you figured that out already.
I did. Rumors spread quickly around here. So how can I be of service?
Ja, dann quetscht man doch mal den Nächsten aus.
Do you know anything about what happened to my grandfather in 81?
It was the work of the devil, I'll say that much. Joseph was a kind man. He did not deserve such a fate. You heard my speech at the funeral, Kathy. I meant every word. He was a great man who did much good for this community.
Did you know him personally?
In a way. He and my father did charity work together. Joseph was around a lot when I was young. They collaborated on a few different projects for the homeless and for the troubled youth, among other things.
So my grandfather was a member of the church?
I wouldn't say that, no. He was a friend of the church, but he wasn't a religious man. He believed only in philanthropy. That being said, Joseph was the person who convinced me to become a priest.
Really?
Oh yes, I was a teenager back then, full of rebellion. Every fiber of my being wanting to distance myself from my father. Joseph made me realize my sinful pride and showed me how I should follow my heart regardless of what others might think. And for that, I'm eternally grateful.
Ja, okay, so viel also schon mal dazu. Wir gehen mal weiter in der Liste.
Does the name Lily Myers mean anything to you?
It does. I was a substitute teacher in her high school for some time before I was ordained.
Really? Did you know her personally?
We weren't close. I only knew her as much as a teacher would know any student.
All right. So, how did she seem toward the end?
For one, she started skipping school a lot. And when she did show up, she was absent-minded and moody. She always looked depressed and hunched down like she had a whole world on her shoulders.
Any idea of what caused this change?
Not a clue. All I know is that when she returned from that last summer break, she was a whole different person.
Do you know who Jimmy Cochran is?
I don't recognize that name, no.
Do you know anything about an art theft at the Wade Estate in the 80s?
I have just a vague memory of reading about it in the paper.
Care to tell me the history of the church?
I'd be happy to. The story is a fascinating one. This church was founded by my father, William T. Price, in the 70s. Back then, he made his living as a traveling salesman and was driving through this area, as he'd done so many times before. However, this day was different. My father held dark thoughts in his mind. He was angry, thinking of evil deeds, even considering swerving off the road into a rock and ending it all. Then suddenly, divine intervention. Three bright lights appeared. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, the sign of God. This epiphany was the moment my father had been waiting for. He sold all of his belongings and took me and my brother to live with him here in Conwell Springs. Soon thereafter, he built this church and started gathering followers. They began to refer to him as Father Bill.
I take it that window up there resembles what he saw when he had this epiphany?
Indeed. The stained glass window depicts the Holy Trinity as witnessed by my father.
Do you know exactly when or where this event took place?
Why do you ask?
Oh, just curious. It's a captivating story.
Well, it was in the spring of 1971, but my father never told anyone where.
Okay, so what happened then?
People flocked to Father Bill. He started teaching, writing scripture. The church flourished and continued to grow all the way up until his sudden death in 1983. That's when I stepped in to take leadership of the church.
I take it that the church started declining after the death of Father Bill?
Yes. Naturally so. With such a magnetic personality, he was irreplaceable. But I assure you, the church is still very much thriving.
Looks kinda empty to me.
It's not really our peak hours.
What's up with you handing out pamphlets at funerals then? Trying to reel people in at a weak moment?
I'm going to assume you meant no disrespect, child. I'm simply providing divine guidance when it's needed the most.
Okay, damit haben wir dann schon mal die Story von der Kirche abgehakt. Ich habe so einen Verdacht, wo Offenbarung stattgefunden hat und ob nicht vielleicht das eine oder andere rote Blümchen damit zu tun hat. Wer weiß.
This may sound strange, but have you heard of or seen a strange man dressed in red?
Only our Lord and Savior Jesus. Surely his rags were drenched in blood as he lay upon the cross.
That's not what I meant. I mean someone here, in Conwell Springs.
Are you joking? I haven't seen a person like that, no.
Oh, hätte sein können.
Do you know who Franklin Goldfarb is?
I am afraid not, my child.
Ja, gut, den Verdacht haben wir ja selber. Und das werden wir jetzt dann auch in Kürze überprüfen. Aber
that's all I need for now, Father.
May the Lord shine his light on you.
Ich würde vorschlagen, da machen wir dann eine neue Folge draus. Und deswegen sage ich an der Stelle wie immer, danke fürs Zuschauen, macht's gut und ciao, ciao.